Singapore's president set to arrive in the Philippines tomorrow, August 15, for a three-day state visit. This will be Tharman Shanmugaratnam's first visit to the country since being elected Singapore's head of state in 2023. Malacanang says the two leaders will hold a bilateral meeting, with President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. reaffirming the Philippine government's commitment to strengthening collaboration with Singapore. The two leaders will also witness the signing of Memorandum of Understanding on the recruitment of Filipino healthcare workers and collaboration on climate financing. McDonald's France has a bone to pick with U.S. basketball team captain Stephen Curry. It jokingly said it is considering pulling curry sauce off its menu after Curry blocked France's bid for the men's basketball gold. It continued the banter on social media platform X with its U.S. counterpart offering to take the sauce. Team USA bagged the men's basketball gold after Curry's four three-pointers widened their lead in the final minutes of the championship game. Asian markets ended Wednesday trade mostly higher after soft U.S. producer prices data overnight raised hopes the Fed will be able to cut rates in September. Japan's Nikkei 225 climbed 0.6% despite a slight wobble after Prime Minister Fumio Kishida said he will not seek re-election as a ruling party leader, ending a three-year term. The local bourse also joined the rally, picking up gains ahead of the Philippine Central Bank's decision tomorrow, Thursday.
I don't think that the BSP should go for a rate cut, primarily because as what the governor noted in the Senate interview is that the main primary directive of the BSP is to contain inflation, and being data dependent, as what they said. As you know, inflation is still high. In fact, it actually surged to 4.4% in the prior month. So, in no way, from that key variable alone, that inflation is already contained. I understand that the BSP is receiving a lot of pressure.
The Philippine peso touches a 56 to the dollar level for the first time in 4 months. The local currency closed at 56.955 Wednesday. Finance Secretary Ralph Recto says they expect the peso to hit the 55 to the dollar level by next year.
I think we're on track. For this year, it is roughly 56 to 58. In fact, for next year, we're looking at 55 to 58. It seems like the peso is appreciating.
The Philippines gets a credit rating upgrade, the first for the Marcos administration. Japan debt watcher R&I raised its rating for the country to A- with a stable outlook from BBB+. It cites the Philippines' macroeconomic stability, high economic growth path, and improvement in fiscal balance. This is as it recognized the Marcos administration's PPP-based infrastructure push, reducing the fiscal burden on the government. RNI further says it is optimistic about the country's economic growth in the medium to long term, given the government's efforts to ease regulations to boost private investments. The Philippine finance chief admits the country's sovereign wealth fund is still scouting for its first investments. This is as he bared during a budget hearing at the Senate that Maharlika Investment Fund has no allocation in the proposed 6.35 trillion peso spending plan for 2025.
There is no subsidy in the 2025 NEP for Maharlika. Admittedly, it is taking time to identify investments that the Maharlika can make. As you know, it is like a startup. They're looking for employees. We're determining the pay packages to be given to the employees of the Maharlika, and they're scouting for investments.